powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad. I want to appreciate everyone that is viewing this broadcast from around the world. It's always a joy to bring forth the engrafted word of God that is able to save your soul and bring supernatural deliverance to you irrespective of any situation you're going through right now. God has so much to do with you. Today we're talking about lose your financial increase. You can lose your finances. God wants us to be productive in the area of our finance. You see, the enemy knows that if the believer is broke, if the church is broke, if the people of God cannot take care of things, he's going to make a mockery of the gospel. And the enemy likes to make the mockery of the gospel, especially when he causes most God's people to believe that prosperity is not the will of God, especially financial prosperity. God has called us to experience increase. He wants us to be able to finance kingdom projects. God wants us to be able to help people, those in need, those who are going through financial problems, those who are losing their homes, those who are losing their cars, those who are not able to take their children to school, those who are going through difficulties. God wants us to help them. But you can't truly help them if you don't prosper. So financial prosperity is also a proof of our covenant benefits. I said financial prosperity is also a proof of our covenant benefit. And God wants us to see increase on every side. Poverty steals joy. Poverty will lead to frustration. One of the reasons for high rate of crime and fraud today in our society is as a result of poverty. This is one of the reasons why there is a high crime rate. There is a high crime of fraud. People taking advantage of people because of the stench of poverty. When people are poor emotionally, poor mentally, poor spiritually and financially, it becomes difficult for them to be productive. But God wants us to be productive in every area of our life. In Psalm 71 verse 21. Psalm 71 verse 21, it said, "Thou shall arise and increase my greatness and comfort me on every side." Thou will increase my greatness on every side. Our God is the God who brings increase. If you look at the ministry of Jesus carefully, he helped people in the time of need. He helped people when they are going through financial challenges, career challenges, when they were going through a difficult season of their lives. Jesus stepped in and resolved the problem. He fed 5,000 people. A poor person can do that. A broke person can do that. A broke person cannot be able to take care of 5,000 people. A man who is broke can do that. Financial prosperity is the will of God. And when believers prosper financially, they are able to carry out the will of God in the times of projects, in the times of crusade, evangelism, you know, writing books, you know, giving the books for free. Some preachers can't give their books for free because they need to recover the finances they're using writing the book. But you see, when there is a financial prosperity, people could easily share, people could easily give without struggle. Can I say this to you? God wants his people to prosper financially. So today we're saying, lose your financial increase. Lose the money. You need to lose what belongs to you. You need to exercise authority over your finances. There is an enemy. And the mission of this enemy is to ensure that the people of God fails in the area of financial prosperity. He knows that financial prosperity empowers. He knows that financial prosperity helps more people to receive spiritual things. One of the ways people could receive spiritual things is when someone supports the kingdom vision. You know, I'm ministering right now to people and you're watching this broadcast right now. It's not for free. We need to get an airtime to be able to run this. We need to be able to subscribe to the internet company to have data, to have things, to have good bandwidth, you know, to be able to preach this gospel to people. But they don't give it to us for free. We have to pay them. If we don't pay them, they disconnect it, so people cannot receive. So financial prosperity is one of the keys that help people to receive spiritual things, like the teaching of God's word. You watch the word of God on television, you listen to it on the internet, somebody is paying for it. One way or the other, there is a cost involved. But a poor church cannot do much. A broke believer cannot do much. A believer that is broke financially cannot do much. So God wants his people to prosper. In 3 John verse 2, it said, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. The prosperity of your soul, your emotional prosperity, your mental prosperity, your spiritual prosperity would lead to the manifestation of material prosperity, would lead to manifestation of financial prosperity. It's time to lose your money. It's time to begin to talk to your finances. You know, Jesus said, if you can say to this mountain, be thou removed, and doubt not in your heart, you will have whatsoever you say. He said, if you doubt not in your heart, so how much are you expecting? What are you believing God right now? A lot of people are out there. They are believers full with the Holy Ghost, but there is no faith expectation. There is nothing they are believing God for. What are you believing God for? Are you believing God to take care of some orphans? Are you believing God to build schools to help people? Are you believing God to go into evangelism, into missions, into missionary work to be able to minister to people? Are you believing God to support those who are going through financial hardship? What are you truly believing God for? So whatever we are believing God for can also determine the amount of money we need to begin to expect, because God is a provider. God provides for those who believe that he can provide for them. God provides for those who believe that he can provide for them. So God wants to provide for this vision. God wants to provide for you as you can be a blessing to people. So what is your expectation? How much are you expecting to receive this year? How much are you willing to sow this year? How much are you willing to come into this year as you can be able to help in the preaching of the gospel? You see, the gospel cannot go forward except people finance it. Yes, that is what happened. As look at Jesus, the ministry of Jesus. Jesus had these women that were supporting his ministry. The Bible said they ministered to him out of their substance. They ministered to Jesus out of their substance. So if they have no substance, what are they going to minister to? If you look at the John Gospel chapter 6, about the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 small fishes, you will notice that the lad has a bread. Imagine the lad came to the meeting without a bread. Do you know it takes money to bake a bread? Do you know it takes money to buy a fish? But this lad came with a bread, he came with a fish. Those are resources. That is a material resources. When Jesus wanted to do the miracle, you know what happened? He took the 5 loaves and the 2 small fishes and he prayed and God brought multiplication. Can I say this to you, people of God? It's time to lose your increase. But we cannot lose our increase if we are ignorant of our increase. Money is coming to you. Increase is coming to you. This is the will of God for you. This is the purpose of God for you. This is God's intention for you, that you come into supernatural finances, that you come into supernatural release of increase, that you come into abundance of finances, as you can be able to minister to those in need. The scripture said that God giveth seed to the sower. You know why he gives seed to the sower? As the sower can determine his future. He gives it to the sower as the sower can be a blessing. He gives it to the sower as the sower can empower others to make a difference. He gives it to the sower as the sower can help in the mission of moving the kingdom of God forward. So he gives it to the sower. So God is a God who, our God is a God who gives you joy. So it's time to lose your finances so you can begin to call increase. Now, one of the ways we're going to lose our finances is when we begin to have supernatural ideas. Supernatural ideas, ideas to create wealth. One of the ways we lose money, lose finances, we lose our finances, is to have supernatural ideas to create wealth. Maybe God may be dropping a word in your heart to go into business, to go into one area of life, to create some goods and services. And he said, I will bless the work of your hands. So one of the ways we experience the blessing is when we have the work of our hands. So the work of our hands will begin to cause increase to come into our life, especially when that work, we are led into it by the Spirit of God. You know, the Holy Ghost wants to show you what to do. The Holy Ghost wants to reveal what you should be doing. The Spirit of God wants to show you what to do about your business, about your job, about your calling. The Holy Ghost wants to show you what to do. People of God, it's time for we to believe God for multi-billion dollar ideas. It's time to believe God for multi-billion dollars ideas. Lord, give me ideas. Lord, give me ideas. Ideas of goods and services. Ideas of product. Now, the Spirit of God is a designer. The Spirit of God can create ideas in your spirit, can drop ideas in your spirit. And it comes in form of imagination. And the idea comes that you can go into this business, you can go into this area of life, and suddenly you went into that area of life and you start noticing increase, supernatural ideas for wealth generation. We know about the wealth of the sinners coming to the church. We know about that. But God also wants to bring us into a place of supernatural ideas. Ideas to generate wealth. So begin to believe God for supernatural ideas. Consigning products, consigning service, consigning sales, consigning exchange, whatever the Spirit of God may be saying to you in this season is something to run with. So believe God for idea. One of the ways that we lose our finances, we lose it from every limitation, is when we begin to have supernatural idea. God didn't call us into losses. God called us to win. God called us to increase. God called us to experience supernatural provision. So supernatural ideas comes by the Spirit that enable us to generate or create resources, wealth, abundance. He said, I'm the Lord your God, I give you the power to get wealth. He said, it's God who gives the power to get wealth. You know, a lot of people, maybe some religious people can criticize prosperity. They can say, it's not good to have money. It's not good to prosper. They can say that. No, I don't care what religious people teach. I'm more interested that God wants you to prosper. I'm more interested that you cannot successfully carry out your purpose on the edge when you're broke. Imagine your son came to you and said, Mom, I want to eat biscuits. Mom, I want to buy granite. I want to buy yam or something, you know. I want to cook something. I want to eat something. And you told them there is no food because there is no money. God doesn't want you in that situation. God doesn't want you in the place of lack, because lack is not a manifestation of the goodness of God. Lack limits divine purposes in the earth. One of the ways Satan hinders most of the work of God in the earth is when he causes ignorant believers or people who lack the knowledge of what true prosperity is, he causes them not to walk in abundance. Then he hinders the purpose of God in their lives. Whatever God is calling you to do may require some financial support. Whatever God is calling you to do. If God asks you to write a book, you're going to pay the printing press, the printing company. If God calls you to maybe to do orphanage, you're going to take some, you need some money to do that. If God calls you to support a ministry, you need money to do that. So there is a reason why God wants us to lose our finances. We can say money, thou art loose. So God wants you to come into supernatural overflow as you can become a vessel of honor, a vessel of blessing. He said to Abraham, I will bless you and you will become a blessing. That is what he said. This ministry continues today because our partners keep partnering. People keep supporting. God keeps supporting us. God keeps helping us. And God uses people to move a vision forward. Whenever God wants to move a vision forward, he uses people to do that. And the people he's going to use are people who have received provision, people who have received increase, and they support the kingdom of God. So I'm praying for you right now to receive a supernatural idea of what to do in this season. Idea to generate wealth. Idea to create wealth. The Holy Ghost is going to give you inspiration of what to write. He's going to give you an inspiration of what to say. He's going to give you an inspiration concerning the product, concerning the service. He's going to give you an inspiration to discover a problem. One of the ways that we can release our finances and lose our finances is when we discover a problem and we solve that problem. HIV is a problem. Somebody needs a solution. Meaning there are many sicknesses and diseases today that people are struggling with. But anybody who gets the solution will be able to make so much money out of it. And for that reason, God wants to give his people supernatural ideas that will produce supernatural solution to solve natural problems. Every natural problem needs some supernatural solution. Maybe it's a medical problem, it's a legal problem, it's a financial problem. Nations are shaken, kingdoms are shaken. So this is the time for the people of God to walk in supernatural increase, because supernatural increase will mobilize you to carry out the kingdom agenda. Most people today are frustrated because of their inability to finance their project, finance their ministry, finance their vision. There are many pastors today that left ministry and they went into business. They refused to pastor anymore. You ask them, why are you no longer pastor? They say, I don't want to spend my time. Nobody's helping me. Let me go and look for business to do. A lot of people that are supposed to be in their calling walk away from their calling because of their financial situation. They couldn't pay their bills. The church lost the property. You know, their children couldn't go to school and the crisis was everywhere. So why will somebody tell me that God does not want his people to prosper financially? Who is that? Who is saying that? God wants his people to prosper. The devil is a liar. The devil wants the church to be broke. So he has to raise religious teachers that will teach against financial prosperity. He raises religious teachers among us to begin to attack the message of finances, to begin to attack the message of prosperity. They attack it so much that many believers are tired when it comes to financial prosperity. They say, well, I don't want any money. I just want to live like this. And they are in debt. They are owing so much they can't pay out of their debt. Everything is on debt. No way. It's time to lose your money. It's time to take your resources. It's time to say, God, I'm going to stand on your word. Your word said, my God will supply all my need according to his riches in glory. My financial need, my emotional need, my spiritual need, my mental need, whatever the need is, he said, my God will supply all my need. This is what the word of God teaches. He said, they that do know their God, he said, they will be strong and they will do exploits. Financial prosperity is one of the keys to overcoming satanic strategies in these last days. One of the ways we are going to overcome satanic strategies is when we prosper financially. You notice what they are doing in that nightclub is the wrong thing they are doing in that nightclub, and then the nightclub want to shut down, and they say, who's going to buy it? We'll go and buy over the nightclub and put a church there in that nightclub. They say this casino is going down. We'll go and buy the casino and start a Bible club there. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. They say that government property is going on for sale, we go and buy it over and start a ministry preaching the word of God. Yeah, start a ministry where people can receive the word of God. But if we don't have the finances, the heathen will buy it and they'll continue in their wickedness. If we don't buy the nightclub over, the strippers will continue to be there. Can I say this to the people of God? Financial prosperity will also open doors for spiritual revival. I said financial prosperity will also open door for spiritual revival. Some places there is no revival because there is no money. Kalika Faranto, Melika Klatoske Toranta Rapido Kaparanto. Let me say this to you, people of God. Abundance is the will of God. Can somebody say that right now? Abundance is the will of God. Some revival will come by finances, I'm telling you. Oh my God. A dear man of God said, if you got the money, then you're ready for the revival. Because you can be able to get the tent, you can be able to do the advert, you can be able to invite people. There are those that need food to eat right now. If you give them meal, one meal, and they can listen to you, preach to them. You can give them food, they don't want to listen to the gospel. They don't want to hear that.